Have you ever wished you could toggle a circuit on and off with a simple push button? Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to build a latching relay circuit using a 555 timer. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. One red LED, one 10 microfarad capacitor, one 150 ohms resistor, three 10,000 ohms resistors, six jumper wires, one NE555 timer IC or integrated circuit, one latch switch, four 1.5 volts battery or 6 volts for the power source, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Starting from the right is pin 1, which is ground or the ground supply. Pin 2 is trigger. It is used to start the timing interval in both monostable and a stable modes. Pin 3 is output. It delivers the result of the timer's operation based on its mode, either monostable, a stable, or bistable. Pin 4 is reset. It is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 is control. It allows you to control the threshold voltage levels that the internal comparators use to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6 is threshold. It monitors the voltage of the capacitor connected to the circuit. Pin 7 is discharge. It controls the charge and discharge cycle of the timing capacitor. Pin 8 is VCC. It is responsible for supplying the power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Start by placing the 555 timer IC onto the breadboard. Remember, the pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left. For this circuit, I will rotate the IC so pin 1 is at the bottom right. I will insert the 555 in the middle of the breadboard. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have any questions about the circuit connections. I will also insert the push button switch in the middle below the 555. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2, or trigger to pin 6, or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 8 or VCC to pin 4 or reset. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Turn the breadboard to the side. Connect a red LED to pin 3 or output with the positive leg attached to pin 3. Bend the ends of a 150 ohms resistor. Add a 150 ohms resistor between the negative leg of the LED and the negative rail. Insert a 10,000 ohms resistor between pin 3 and one side of the push button switch. Rotate the breadboard to the other side. Insert a jumper wire from pin 6 to the other side of the push button switch. Insert a 10,000 ohms resistor from pin 8 to the same side of the push button switch. It's in the same row as the previous jumper wire. Turn the breadboard to the vertical position again. Both negative terminals on the power rails are used. Connect the negative rails with a jumper wire. It's time to connect the power supply. Connect the negative lead of the battery holder to the negative rail. Connect the positive lead of the battery holder to the positive rail. The LED lights up, which is a good sign. If you press the switch, the LED turns off. If you press it again, the LED turns on. We have successfully completed the circuit. Let's take a closer look at how this circuit works. The 555 timer operates in bistable mode, meaning it remains either on or off until triggered. This behavior is controlled by two key pins, pin 2 or trigger and pin 6 or threshold. Pin 2 activates the output when the voltage drops below 1/3 of the supply voltage, while pin 6 deactivates the output when the voltage rises above 2/3 of the supply voltage. When the push button is pressed, the capacitor temporarily lowers the voltage at pin 2, triggering the output and turning the LED on. The capacitor charges up while the LED is on, maintaining the state even after the button is released. Pressing the button again discharges the capacitor, sending a high voltage to pin 6, which turns the LED off. I hope this video has shown you how to make a latching relay circuit with a 555 timer. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.